In this module, we will look broadly at ethical principles and moral obligations that extend to the paramedic. Once completed with this module, you should be able to define morals, define ethics, discuss the application of ethics and the use of ethical values, and examine ethical conflicts. At the onset, be aware that there are courses dedicated entirely to the study of morals and ethics. Some go further to explore those concepts within the auspices of various professions, and healthcare professions are often targeted by such courses as there are numerous scenarios where morality, ethics, and the law may very well collide. This particular module will provide just a very brief overview of morals and ethics within the practice of EMS as a paramedic. To begin, it is necessary to understand the difference between morals and ethics. While there are numerous definitions available, we will recognize morals as governing an individual's own personal beliefs as to right versus wrong. Essentially, morals are intrinsically driven. They are guiding principles for one's life based upon personal and spiritual decisions. While morals can be influenced by society, culture, and religion, they are very individualized and differ from person to person. Ethics, on the other hand, is more extrinsically driven. Ethics are commonly recognized as a set of rules governing conduct within a particular group, culture, or profession. Ethics are usually uniform, without much variation between cultures, religions, or other societal influencers. Given this differentiation, one may find it interesting to find out that ethics is often referred to as moral philosophy, which is a brand of philosophy that involves systematizing, defending, and recommending concepts of right and wrong governing individualized conduct. Given this philosophical background, ethics is often used to evaluate morality and define concepts and resolve questions related to good and evil, right and wrong, justice and crime, and other related seemingly mutually exclusive concepts. As an example of how morality varies from ethics, consider a case where a paramedic is asked to provide treatment to an unsavory person, such as a perpetrator of a horrible crime. Morally, the paramedic may have a huge problem with what his or her patient did, yet that paramedic has an ethical duty to provide high-quality care regardless of his or her personal moral reservations. Given that ethics as applied to the paramedic are defined by the overall profession, which consists of individual providers who must deem what conduct within the profession of EMS is considered moral, and those underlying moral beliefs are different for everyone, ethical conduct in some circumstances can be difficult to establish. Occasionally, two different moral imperatives seem to conflict with each other, which creates an ethical conflict, dilemma, or paradox for those within the profession. One such conflict in EMS involves situations related to the delivery of what would arguably be futile care. Have you ever provided resuscitative efforts to a cancer patient who is obviously approaching the end of his or her journey, not because you thought it was the best thing for the patient, but because your protocols required it, given that the patient did not have a do not resuscitate order or bracelet? Another example would be initiating resuscitative efforts in a remote area where it is not possible to reach a definitive care facility within a reasonable period of time, such as a wilderness area. Is it ethical to provide resuscitation to a person you know or believe in your heart is undeniably dead and cannot be resuscitated, or even if he or she was resuscitated, the resulting quality of life is arguably no better than being dead? Maybe your protocols require it, tying your hands, yet should a paramedic be blindly following an offline protocol when he or she is in a situation that was arguably not considered in the protocol given a particular set of circumstances? Another EMS ethical conflict is known as medical rationing. What does EMS do when it only has limited resources to mitigate a broad emergency? Think in terms of triage. There is a gray triage category where the patient is not dead yet, but you suspect the patient will probably die even with your intervention, and you know the patient will certainly die without that intervention. You arguably need to use your limited resources to help the most viable patients, to do the best you can for the most you can. Is it moral, however, to essentially ignore someone who gravely needs your help, even if there are others who also need your help? How much time, energy, equipment, and supplies do you expend on one person, knowing full well those resources will not be available to help others who have a better chance of survival? Professional misconduct may give rise to an ethical conflict if some unique circumstances apply. Take an abusive patient, for example. Does the EMS provider have a right to defend him or herself from an abusive patient? To what point is a certain amount of force acceptable versus unacceptable? What about restraining a patient, either physically or pharmacologically? Would any of those actions constitute patient abuse? What if the restraint was used not to defend oneself, but for the purpose of convenience for the provider? Another ethical conflict involves the withholding of resources and services based solely upon financial considerations. This was a huge problem years ago with hospitals, which gave rise to the EMTALA law we discussed in a previous module. Hospitals used to refuse to treat patients who could not afford their services. This is obviously horrible for the patient, but the flip side of the argument is that healthcare organizations only have a certain amount of money available to sustain their operations. Similar to the allocation of limited resources ethical conflict, the limited resource here is money. Is it right to refuse medical care to someone because they cannot afford it? To contrast the question, the money to treat those who cannot pay must come from somewhere. Is it right to shift that burden to others? These are just some examples of ethical conflicts within healthcare professions. Some of these conflicts have been resolved for us, sometimes by the passing of a law. Economic triage is a great example of where the profession itself failed to regulate its own ethics, and the lawmakers stepped in to pass a law making such conduct illegal, even if some did not consider withholding emergency care to those people to be immoral or unethical. Some of those conflicts still exist today, including others not denoted here on this slide, such as physician-assisted suicide or DNR orders for a minor patient. Many are very high-profile, politically charged issues as well, such as the right to have an abortion versus the rights of an unborn child. As our technology and medical knowledge and available interventions continues to grow, there will probably be new ethical quandaries that emerge in years to come that we never would have anticipated previously. We obviously cannot resolve these conflicts here and now. As an EMS provider studying to be a paramedic, however, the likelihood of being involved in a scenario that gives rise to an ethical conflict at some point in your career will probably increase once you have that paramedic license, as your scope of practice and expectation of utilizing critical thinking also increases. You are the future of the profession and may find yourself in a position where you are involved in discussions to further define or clarify ethical conduct for the profession. Having a broad understanding of morals, ethics, and related conflicts may prove very helpful to assist you in resolving existing or future ethical conflicts for the benefit of the system and the patients you serve. This ethical conflict resolution will be discussed more in the next module. Given your completion of this module, you should now be able to define morals, define ethics, discuss the application of ethics and the use of ethical values, and examine ethical conflicts. In the next module, you will build on this information and look at ethical tests used in healthcare decision making. This presentation was prepared by Waukesha County Technical College in Pewaukee, Wisconsin, and is distributed with an attribution, non-commercial, share-alike 4.0 International Creative Commons license, copyright 2019 Waukesha County Technical College. For information on WCTC's numerous fire and EMS educational offerings, please visit us online at wctc.edu.